Hey guys, Riske here, and welcome back to Sherlock Holmes, Chapter 1. So, last we left off, things were very different. I'm gonna say right now, I apologize if the setup is kind of odd, or if, like, the fan's too loud, or things are just weird. I'm still getting used to the new place, and trying to figure out my recording setup, so just bear with me. Things might be awkward for a little bit. Last we left off, I quite honestly don't fucking remember. Oh, right! The Dueling Club. Okay. So, where do I need to go? Do I need to go back into the building, I guess? Hold on, is there anything in the mind pad? No. Okay. I was engaged in a fight with two members of the Blind Dueling Club and won, but it seems there was a third person here. I believe we talked to him. I think. Pretty sure. Where the hell? Okay, Church of St. Nicholas. Blind Dueling Club, okay. Right. Sorry, it's been a minute since we played, so I have to get refamiliarized. Because, yeah, I remember we did the duel, and we talked to the guy. Wait, isn't that the way we came in? Oh. Right. You.
Can we just get this over with?
Okay, so I guess there's nothing else to say here. Oh.
Your ability to perceive the world can be developed through work and concentration.
Okay. Sure. A token of your gratitude for your generosity.
How to sharpen one's senses.
Okay. I don't remember all this.
Addressed to Heinrich von Kram and written with a nervous hand.
Can I read it?
Addressed to Heinrich von Kram and written with a nervous hand.
I guess not. It's kind of lame. I want to read it.
Just yesterday.
Oh, there we go. Eric, having a von Kram in the position of honorary consul is the only way to earn the respect of other countries. Your name is too small for the state position. My noble Prussian family is the guarantee that the empire can and will stand above all other nations. H.V. von Kram. Eric's response is written on the other side of the letter. Henrik, good grief, what nonsense. Your family line has been corrupted by excess. You're the last and best example of this decadence, this fin de race, of dying breed. Our empire needs better men, stronger, more modern. Do you truly believe such a superficial person, burdened with debts, gambling, and his blood, should be entrusted with the responsibilities of the state? Moreover, have you ever known a disabled person to be held up as the figurehead of his country? I am the only legitimate candidate to replace the German honorary consul in Cordona. Spare yourself the embarrassment and withdraw your candidacy before your weaknesses are made public. Yvonne Staub. Good God. Yikes. That's kind of harsh. Okay. Professor Stoltz, ophthalmologist, Kohnkinder Krankenhaus. Man, the Germans have some wild names. I'm just gonna throw that out there. I am part German, so I can say that. Von Kram family donates 5,000 to the Köln Children's Hospital, 1865. But I mean, that was 15 years ago, so, like, that doesn't mean he's still cool beans, you know? Oh, right. This was where the battle happened. Gotcha. Okay. Okay, so there's a couple things I need to discuss with him then. Listen here, you piece of shit. Oh. I mean, should I accuse? Do I have enough to accuse?
You and Eric were competing for the position of honorary consul, yes? Quite the title.
We were, but he stood no chance. Only a true nobleman could take such a role.
Difficult for him to contest it now. Mr. von Kram, I know you murdered Eric von Staub.
You joke, I didn't do it.
On the contrary, when the opportunity arose, you pounced.
Oh, dear God, okay.
That doesn't make any sense at all. And furthermore, I had no reason to want Eric dead.
I mean, I disagree. Let's see. Collection of telegrams. I don't know that that really has anything to do with it. Okay, yeah, that doesn't have anything to do with it.
Actually, you had a motive.
That's ridiculous.
No, it's not. And I know what you used to kill your friend, too.
Okay, the revolver seemed right. It's just hard because I'm like, are the exes bad or does it just mean that, you know, we've done two out of our three evidence things? I don't know. I don't know what that means. Official German correspondence. Letter to Mr. Boddington. That doesn't have anything to do with anything. Thank you for your recent statement of debts owing. I don't think that has anything to do with it.
You really do think it was me, don't you? Honestly, I'm embarrassed for you.
Mr. von Kram, I believe you are the one responsible for Eric von Staub's death. You are now under my arrest and will be escorted to the police.
I have never been so insulted in all my life. I am innocent, as you will soon find out.
Well, oh well. Oh, let's see what John has to say. I'm sure it's not good. We've arrested Mr. von Kram for murder, but I feel uneasy about the situation. I'm not sure we made the right decision. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what y'all want from me. Wait, hold on. Let me change clothes. Can I talk to that one dude? Oh, God damn it. Like anywhere in here I can't change clothes? Okay, there we go. Just can't change clothes in front of him. Gotcha. I can't believe I don't have a police hat. And oh, I do have a police hat. God damn it. I didn't think I had one. How long have I had one?
Are you sure von Kram was lying? I don't know. Arresting him feels wrong.
Well, I mean, they gave me the option to accuse. I don't know. It's sad. I bet everybody we've thrown in jail is innocent. I mean, I know that in the very first case, Luca was definitely the guilty one. He ended up confessing, but it's like, I didn't have that happen in our playthrough. Okay. Saints and sinners. People are talking about a priest who was found dead with his hand severed. The only item of note that the police were able to find was a saw lying next to the body. Despite an ongoing investigation, people are worried that the culprit will escape unpunished. Okay, that's interesting. Iron Coffin, playing the law. John suggested that I should join the police, or at least pretend as much. I shouldn't reveal to any of the suspects that I am not actually an officer. My curiosity has been piqued by talk that Bacillo Capello, the owner of the famous Armor Capello home security company, has been arrested. The situation is quite peculiar. Okay, yeah, let's do this. Unpin and then pin. Okay. Now these are the holding cells, correct? I'm pretty sure it's this door at the very end. There we go. I just needed the cap. How long have I had that damn cap? I swear I didn't see it last time.
May I ask you something?
Oh, I don't know about that.
What's one of the others?
Oh, okay. I mean, I don't know. It gives you the opportunity to talk to somebody, so I want to talk to them. Hey, what up?
Excuse me, are you Mr. Capello? My name is Sherlock Holmes. I'm hoping you could spare a moment to talk.
Manners, what a pleasant surprise. Most of your colleagues have lacked even the simplest of common courtesies.
You're a suspect, sir, but not yet a criminal. I shan't treat you as such. Your case is refreshingly unusual, and I wish to get to the bottom of it.
Manners and enthusiasm. May you go far, young man. What can I help you with?
Bro, what can't you help me with? Okay. You got something wrong with your nose here. Focused look. Or focused. Is that how that was spelled back then, or is that a typo? Okay, got a nice little tie. Fresh and fashionable. Okay. What's wrong with your hand? You're married. Tight on the finger. Gained some weight? That's the crime of all back in the 18 whatevers. Or wait, was being fat a good thing back then? Wasn't that a symbol of opulence because you could actually, you know, afford to eat? Or am I making all of that up? Okay, what am I missing with this dude? There's one more thing. It's not his shoes. Doesn't seem to be his pants. Oh, there we go. Recent trauma from a bruised hand. Okay, so he's either methodical, he's the local proprietor of the famous Armor Capello safe lock door and home security company in Cordona. He's currently being held in the police station holding cells as the prime suspect for Niccolo Detti's murder. Niccolo Detti. He's in his early 40s, a methodical man who puts business and principles above all else. Keeps calm and focused despite being arrested, has a bruise on his hand, probably had to defend himself recently, and values his family life. Okay, or he has a flair for the new and fashionable, keeps his frustrations bottled up while at the police station, but could be prone to violence. He has a bruise on his hand, which might be the result of a fight attached to his family. I mean, I don't know. I kind of see him more as methodical. We'll go with that. Yeah, we'll go with that.
You are surprisingly composed for a man accused of murder. Not so easily shaken, I take it.
Life is full of surprises. You'd be astonished how many deals go sour due to a force majeure. One becomes skilled at adapting. I am confident this will all be set straight. Until then, I will endure.
Much how you endure that injured hand. Those bruises look painful, but you seem barely aware of it. Were you attacked?
Ah, no. A minor accident, nothing more. My heady days as a man out to prove his valor are far behind me. I now know that to succeed in life, one must stay calm and plan ahead. The world will turn your way eventually. And if it does not, then one must persuade it so.
Start at the beginning.
Please, tell me how you ended up in this situation.
Well, this morning some clients arrived to finalize their purchase of a Capello modular safe. But when we opened the door, out tumbled a dead man.
And I take it this wasn't normal?
No, I normally keep my corpses in the wardrobe. Please, young man, spare me your wit. The rest of the day was a blur. I recognized the victim, and it seemed so did the police. That was enough to make me the main suspect.
Who sent for the authorities?
No one. As it happens, we had a break-in last night. Nothing was stolen, but for insurance purposes, the report had to be made. So, police officers just happened to be on the premises when we discovered the body in the safe.
You mentioned you were showing your wares to some prospective buyers when the safe was opened. Who were they?
Clerks from the bank. They inspected the safe from top to bottom yesterday. I assume the sale was just a formality at that point.
And the safe was closed?
It's usually open, but it locks automatically when the door swings closed. That's another marvelous Capello invention.
A coffin that locks itself. Marvelous indeed. Help me grasp your movements yesterday. What time did you meet the customers from the bank, and did you have any other appointments?
Yesterday, the bank clerks arrived at 10 a.m. Afterwards, I was alone in the office until my wife Augusta came in at 3 p.m. I left for home at 6:30 p.m.
And what about this morning?
Our meeting for the demonstration was set for 9 a.m. I arrived about half an hour prior in order to prepare.
I have one final inquiry. Do you recall the time at which the safe door was closed?
Young man, I may just as well ask you when you closed your cigar case. I have opened our safes a dozen times a day for a dozen years. I do not recall.
You say you became the suspect when the police identified the victim. Is there history between you?
Surely you jest. That man and I have never met and never would, unless he became the first detty in history to use our products.
Some sort of family feud? I'm afraid I'm not familiar.
You must be new to Cordona. It's an old tale. Back in Italy, generations ago, the Dettis tried to ruin our family business. They nearly succeeded. The Capellos rightfully struck back, but there has been bad blood ever since.
And does that blood flow in you too?
I told you, sir, it's an old story. Or it was. I fear this horrible event portends worse to come. My wife may be in danger as we speak.
I'd like to inquire about the burglary.
I'm not sure I see the connection, but if you wish to know more, talk to Billy Lloyd, the night watchman. He scared off the thief.
Was it also Billy that discovered the burglar?
No, my wife did. She had stayed late yesterday. Poor Augusta. At least she's safer with the police than at home alone.
Well, Mr. Capello, I think that's all I need from you at present. Where can I find your office?
Here, take my card. Billy should be on site to assist with the investigation. And please, sir, would you check on my wife before you depart?
Thank you. I will endeavour to speak with her before I leave the station.
Please, treat her gently. Women lack our resilience when it comes to ordeals like this. I shall eagerly await your return. After all, little else I can do.
Okay. I don't think I'm a fan of him. So, I got the timeline, Priscilla Capello testimony. Okay, so I need to talk to somebody about that. So, people of interest include Night Watchman Billy Lloyd, who was at the Armor Capello office on Adler Street to the east of St. Clement's Cathedral in Scaledio, and then the wife Augusta, who is currently in the police station. Okay, since we're in the police station, let's talk to her first. Is she somewhere down here? Sorry, guys, I took a way bigger hit than I meant to. So I probably understood about half of that conversation. But you know, it's okay. Yeah, I finally got another cart.
Mrs. Capello, okay. Please wait in the office. Wait. The inspector will be here soon.
Wait, where is she? Where you at, bitch? I mean, I assume she's not in a holding cell. That would be kind of extreme. I don't think she's done anything wrong. Okay, there it is. Wait, where were they gonna have her go? Shit. Where you at, lady? Am I crazy? Okay, it's fine. Because it's like, I heard the voice pretty clearly, but I didn't see anybody. Okay, she must be down there. Oh, wait, the inspector. There we go. I'm just slow.
You must be the inspector.
Would you be Augusta Capello?
Must I really repeat myself to every baby-faced man in uniform that strides in?
Forgive me, I am not the inspector, but I am working on your husband's case.
Then I have nothing to say to you. Come back with the inspector in charge so that we may dispense with the endless repetition.
Okay, so I guess I'm gonna have to get a new outfit. Used laudanum recently. She got glassy eyes. She got a little heart brooch, or pin, whatever. Parting gift from 1875. Okay. What's her ring about? Marks from fidgeting. You nervous about something? Shocked. Has been fidgeting with her wedding ring due to stress. Has recently used laudanum but doesn't seem accustomed to the drug. Or emotional. I mean, she doesn't seem very emotional. She's kind of a frigid bitch. In her late 20s and well, person. Previously involved in music, currently works with her husband. Yeah, I think she's shocked. Yeah, if she's got glassy eyes, I mean, she could like that, though. No, I think she's shocked.
Whilst I prefer German composers, the harp solo from Lucia di Lammermoor stands out as one of Donizetti's finest contributions to the form. I'm sure Basilio thought the same.
He did. How? Did he tell you how we met?
Oh, there was no need. It is trivial to observe how much you value your memories of playing harp in the orchestra, and even an amateur Italian harpist would be familiar with Donizetti's finest work.
Yes. Music is a balm in these uncertain times. It is nice to meet another who appreciates it.
Much as I appreciate the truth. Please, Mrs. Capello, let me help you and your husband.
I am not unappreciative, sir. But I'm afraid I presently lack the strength.
Basilio tells me you were present during the burglary yesterday. What can you tell me about it?
Oh, it gave me such a fright. I fainted, fell to the floor. I wish I could help you, but I'm just utterly useless. Please, I want to rest before the inspector arrives.
Were you familiar with the deceased man found in the safe?
No. I did not know him, nor can I conceive of how the poor soul ended up there.
You've had quite the day, Mrs. Capello. I shall leave you be. If I have further questions, I may visit again later.
All right. That was a thing, so I need to come back. Or, well, I guess maybe we got everything we need from her for now. Okay, so let me go to the Armored Capello office on Adler Street to the east of the cathedral. But yeah, hi guys, how's life? How are things? I'm hanging in there, man. I'm working on it. Okay. On Adler Street. Okay, so we really don't even need to fast travel. We're already pretty close. We can just take Harbor to... what is that? Professor's Road? I wish there were street signs. That would make life way easier. Unless there are and I'm just missing them. Yeah, coming up. And it should be somewhere along here. But yeah, I'm excited to get even further on this game. It's definitely longer than I thought it was going to be, but I'm still enjoying it. Hopefully it doesn't become Mafia 3 and that changes, but I'm still enjoying it so far. It's not feeling like it's dragging on. Yet. That can change pretty quickly, though. Found it. Alright. You know what? We're going to go ahead and investigate him in the next episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, share this with your friends, hit the bell so you don't miss an upload, and I'll see you guys next time.